My name is Julia Margulis. I'm a grad student in the neuroscience program here at UCSF. So our lab, the lab I work in, is interested in studying neurodegenerative diseases, so diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's that I'm sure everybody has heard of, but specifically I study a disease called Huntington's disease, which is sort of the third most common disease after Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. And it's pretty rare, but it's really interesting to us because it's all genetic. So everyone that has Huntington's disease has a specific genetic mutation. On a day-to-day basis, I work mostly with cells. And so in our lab, we take organisms and we do these dissections to actually get the individual cells. And then we can add in the specific genetic mutation that causes Huntington's disease. And then we can kind of watch to see what happens with the cells. And we do a lot of microscopy in the lab. And specifically, actually, my mentor has developed this really cool microscope. We call it a robotic microscope. And so what the microscope can do is actually, it can, you know, you put on kind of a plate of cells, and they're all kind of labeled with different colors, and it can actually return to the same cells over and over again and kind of image them over time. So kind of similar to when you do like a clinical trial and you have a group of patients and you bring them in, you know, every week and say, okay, how are you feeling? You know, let's take your blood and do all these different tests. We can put the cells on the microscope and look at them and say, are they still alive? How are they looking? You know, do they have different levels of different proteins or different mutations and things like that? I think I probably got interested in science in high school. So I was really lucky that my science teacher actually set me up with a summer research position, basically working in a lab, and I didn't get paid or anything, but I just got to work in the lab and see what it was like and do kind of simple lab stuff and do little experiments and learn techniques. And so in college, I worked really closely with a postdoctoral fellow in a lab as well doing research. And so I remember we had a speaker come in that worked at the Center for Disease Control, and they talked about working with the Ebola virus. And that just really appealed to me that, you know, first of all, science can be a tool to really improve human health and create treatments and vaccines for different things. But also that by studying, like I said, sort of the small changes in a virus or a protein or a cell, that can really have a huge relevance for something like a disease or a person's health. You know, all of our medical knowledge and knowledge about diseases has to come from somewhere, and that somewhere is, you know, scientists in the lab doing experiments and figuring out how these diseases work. So I think just, you know, on the ground, we absolutely need people to do that work because it's super critical, but also, you know, in our society, I think it's so important to have people that have scientific knowledge and understand, you know, how weather patterns work and how, you know, the process of development and all these things are super relevant to public policy and to the way people make laws. And so I think the more people we have that are trained in science and have been in the lab and understand how these things work, that just the better that's going to be for our society as a whole.